This episode in our Warrior Archetype series, I want to get a little more personal. When I was 29, I think, I lived in a little cottage like this in Northern California. I had saved up $2,700 that I thought would last me for a year, and it did last me for a year, or a year and a half, actually. And I moved into an affordable little cottage like this to try to finish a book. And the backstory of this thing was that 6 years earlier, when I was married, I had spent 2 years trying to write a book with the full support of my family, my wife, the whole thing, and I had completely choked at the finished. I had been like on the 1 yard line, I had fumbled the ball, blew everything up, and had spent like the following 5 or 6 years in a kind of a hellish sort of state on my own, where shame, my own shame at what I had done, what I had failed to do, was sort of tormenting me. And I finally had got it together where I had enough money that I could just work for a year. And my goal was just to finish something. Whether it sold, whether anybody found a publisher, it didn't mean anything to me, but I just had to finish something or I was going to kill myself. And we're talking really here about the inner war. Now this cottage here, this is not the one, but it was sort of like this. It looks like an idyllic setting in a wonderful, charming little town, et cetera, et cetera. But inside that cottage, in the back room where I was working, it was a war. It was a war to the death. And in that point, I had to sort of call upon or find within myself my warrior archetype and my king archetype, the things we're talking about in this series, to maintain my composure over my self-doubt, my tendency to sabotage myself, my fear, my procrastination, all of those things, the fear to go big, the fear to really try hard. And these were compulsions that, you know, I had no control over, that I was just sort of trying to fight on, hang on with my fingernails. And anybody that's done that, any kind of a long-term creative enterprise, knows exactly what I'm talking about. The word is resistance, with a capital R. The wars that we fight, that you and I fight, are not on the battlefield all the time. Sometimes they're in a perfect little setting like this, where the inner war is being fought in a world that nobody else can see from the outside, but that we know. It's in our heart and it's in our head.